Hi, I'm Adam from First Man Photography, and I want to show you how the Loupedeck CT works with Adobe Photoshop. As we look down here at the device, rather than going through your entire workflow, it's the default settings are split up into different things that you might do yourself with Photoshop. And as ever with the Loupedeck CT, it's very customizable. So on the touchscreen here, we have the workspace for retouching, for graphics and vector. You can open Adobe Camera Raw. We have access to basic tools, layers, adjustment layers, and the colors as well. So we're gonna look over here at one of my images from Scotland in the UK. And I just want to make a few adjustments to the color and the brightness a little bit using curves, but I also want to remove these lights down here. So as we go into the basic tools on the device here, I now have control over actually zooming into the image with the main wheel here, which is extremely useful. So I can scroll down and up like that to just view the image at the resolution or the magnification that I want. If I press function and E, I can bring up the hand tool as well, which then just gives me really fine adjustment, and I can move the image around and in and out with the wheel and the mouse in combination there. So I'm going to come down to here and I want to remove these lights. So to start with, I want to create a new layer so I can do all my adjustments in a non-destructive way. So I'm just gonna hit number 5, workspace 5 on the Loupedeck CT to bring up my layers page. I just wanna hit the new layer button on the touchscreen there to bring up a new layer on my screen. I'm now going to go back into workspace 1, which is the basic edits, and I'm going to bring up the spot removal tool. I now have my brush here and I've got the dials on the side which I can use to adjust my brush size. So this first dial here, I can adjust the brush size bigger or smaller depending on the spot I want to move. So I'm just going to make it a tiny bit bigger and remove those first lights there. So I'm just going to remove these couple of other spots there, that one, and this little red light here, which I don't want as well. And then I've got this little cluster of lights here, and I want to just remove them in a different way, just to show you. So I'm going to hit the lasso tool on the Loupedeck CT and just draw a small box around there. And I'm going to use content aware fill to remove these lights here. So I'm going to select the background layer as well, and then come onto the fill page there, and just click content aware fill, and that should remove them. I can then deselect by going into the area page and just hitting deselect just like that. Okay, now I'm gonna zoom out on the image a bit and I want to make a few curves adjustment just to adjust the brightness across the image. So I'm gonna hit 6 to go into the curves workspace. And then I can create an adjustment layer for curves either by clicking on the main wheel here or I've got the option in the touch screen there. So I'm just gonna click on the main wheel to create a curves layer. Now, very usefully, I then just need to move my mouse over my curve here. And using the main wheel, I can then just make very specific adjustments to that curve layer there. So I'm just going to add in a touch more contrast, really, on the dark areas here. So just by turning the wheel, it makes these really fine adjustments. I don't need to move the mouse. I can then just release, and it's made that adjustment. And then you're going to increase the highlights a bit, so move it up to the sort of highlight area, and then just turn the other way to make that moonlight a little bit brighter in the image. Then just release, and that's set. As well as adjusting curves, you can also create adjustment layers for all the other options that Photoshop provides using the Loupedeck CT. I want to show you how you can change the color in Photoshop using the Loupedeck CT as well. So I'm going to go to workspace 5 and create a new layer. I'm then going to come back to the main page and select my brush. I've now got my brush selected, and again, you can make adjustments to that using the wheel there. But if I bring up the color panel here and go to workspace 7 to bring up the colors, I then have on the touch screen here access to the normal range of colors, so like a red there or blue, and you can see that changes on the screen as I press it. So once I've selected the color, I can then make really fine adjustments with the touch screen on the wheel. So I can just move it around like that and select those specific colors. If I turn the main wheel as well, it will adjust the color all the way down the side there. So I'll go down to a green color. I can now make those fine adjustments to get just the right color that I want. That then sets my brush in the foreground. I can do the same for the background. If I hold the function key down and swipe across on the wheel, and that will allow me to move the or change the background color as well. That's then set in my brush for the foreground, and I can draw my brush in like that. I mean, that doesn't look very good, but I can also make adjustments on the brush tool as well. So I can adjust the feather down as well to give it a really sort of soft edge, or go the other way and give it that nice hard edge, depending how you use it. You can also change opacity on that as well to give it sort of the really solid color, or go the complete opposite way to give it a more subtle look. Again, doesn't look too great on this, but Photoshop is so specific to you, that might be how you use it. So I've removed those brush strokes from the picture now, and I want to come down to my layer panel here, because quite often your layer panel will look much more complicated than that, but I still want to keep my workflow tidy and efficient. So I want to just group those layers, and I can do that again using the Loupedeck CT. I can just select the layers that I want to select and then come into workspace 5, and then I have all my layer controls there. So in this case, I just want to very straightforwardly is to group those layers. You can see also there on the Loupedeck CT that you can merge layers, you can duplicate layers, you've got pretty much total control over your layers on this workspace. Depending on how you manage your workflow in Photoshop, it might be that you use a lot of actions, and you can also assign them to a workspace within the Loupedeck software. So I'm going to come back to my image because I'm quite happy with that now and I want to export it. So I can just hit the save button there to bring up the export as, and I can select which way I want to export that. In my case, I'm going to select JPEG and export it from there. As a photographer, the way I use Photoshop is very personal and specific to me, and I'm sure that's the same for you. What the Loupedeck CT allows me to do is move beyond just the default settings that come included with it. I can create my own workspaces to be very specific to all the usual tools that I use in Photoshop. That allows me to be more efficient and get more work done in the way that I'm sure you would like to do as well. I hope you've enjoyed this introduction to using the Loupedeck CT with Adobe Photoshop, and look forward to seeing what you can create.